So now, empathy is basically of two kinds. The affective empathy or emotional empathy is to resonate with someone else's mental state. If someone is very happy and very joyful, then you feel joyful. If someone is sad, you also feel sad. And if someone is suffering, you do really suffer of someone else's suffering. This cognitive empathy, which is to put oneself in others' shoes, to try to imagine what do they think, what do they feel, what is their state of mind. Now, empathy is very important when you take care of people who suffer. Caregivers, for instance, when they are empathic, and then they truly resonate with someone, and therefore it becomes caring empathy or sort of empathic compassion that comes from being concerned by others and then wanting to do something. But also there's a risk. Standalone empathy, imagine that you are a caregiver and day after day you resonate effectively with someone who suffers. And patient after patient, day after day, you feel the suffering of others. Then it becomes overwhelming. That's the burnout. There's a distress and anxiety that comes from being overwhelmed by resonating with others' suffering. That's why you cannot leave empathy alone. You need to bring a much wider warmth from the heart, that is altruistic love and compassion. So standalone empathy is like an electric pump that runs without water. It burns. So you need the positive and constructive emotion or mental state of love and compassion so that you don't burn out. And I think this is something very necessary in the care professions, whether it's medical or taking care of elderly or taking care of people who suffer or at wars, that we do cultivate love and compassion so that empathy is not left on its own.